Did you just get a new boss at work? Losing all the credibility we built up over time is tough. Use the 9 steps from this video to turn this situation into an opportunity and a catalyst for professional growth. My name is Johan Peterson, and today we'll talk about the situation that most of us will go through many times in our lives. Getting a new boss. This video will give you a rock solid approach to building a great relationship with your new boss. Just hold on for 1 second. If you're instead starting a new job, this video is a better match for you. I'll also leave a link for it down in the description. Make sure you bookmark this video though, because sooner or later, you'll get a new boss at the new job too. It's always a significant change in our work lives when we get a new boss. I mean, we all know our old boss well. What makes them happy, what they expect from us, and what we can expect from them. But all of a sudden, it'll happen. Our boss lets us know that he or she is moving on to a new position or a new company. Suddenly, it feels like we have to start over from scratch. The new boss coming in has no knowledge or history or our past performance, except maybe for a hasty handover. All the credibility that you have built up over time is gone in an instant. Mindset is important here. Every time there's any kind of change at work, it's easy to feel anxious. Try to disconnect your feelings from any change at work, making a point out of seeing every change as an opportunity for you. Getting a new manager is one of those times, and you're not looking at it as an opportunity to fool yourself or to feel better. You're doing it because getting a new boss is a big opportunity and a catalyst for professional growth. Transition times between managers are usually very short. That's why it's important for you to ask for a proper handover. A handover where the three of you sit down and run through your performance, your goals, your ambitions. After all this though, you need to be very mindful of how you build the relationship with your new boss. This video will give you 9 steps that you should take as soon as you get a new boss. Show you care. Make a habit out of asking your boss how she or he is doing. This will make them feel noticed and give them a chance to open up to you. Working on building a deeper relationship with your boss is important and will be a big plus for you. It can lead to more transparency for you, as well as more opportunities for you in the future. So make sure you ask your boss, how are you doing, on a regular basis, even though they don't open up the first time you do it. A simple smile at work or when starting a video call will tell your boss, happy to see you, without you saying a word. Get clear on their goals. Make it a point to get crystal clear on your boss's goals. This will help you set goals to align with your boss. It will also give you an understanding of how they are measured and how you can help them reach their goals. I mean, anyone who helps you reach your goals are gonna be in good standing, right? And this is not only to help your boss, because helping your boss will also help the company succeed, because your boss's goal is aligned with their boss, and their boss's goal is aligned with their boss. Understand their schedule. Ask your boss when they're doing heads down work and don't want to be disturbed, as that will help you plan your schedule around your boss's schedule when they're not busy. This will also help you understand when to expect longer response times, or when not to ping them on Slack. How to present information. Ask your boss how they want their information presented to them. Are they a visual person or a person who wants everything backed up with numbers? How much do they want to be looped into the work that you're accountable for? Are there any projects that they want weekly updates for, as an example? The managers that tend to be more deeply involved usually want frequent updates. Different bosses also process information differently. Listeners want to be briefed in person, while readers want to write up first to then discuss in person. Pay attention and adapt. Pay really close attention to what your boss expects from their people and their teams. Analyze how they make decisions, negotiate, and how he or she gains input. You also want to pay attention to what people influence them the most and what approach those people take. And then you can even adapt your leadership and decision-making style to theirs. Whenever your boss speaks, listen. Listen. Whether work-related or something completely different, make sure you keep it on your mind for the future. And make sure your body language shows you're paying attention too. Nod your head, keep eye contact, and lean forward. That shows you're paying attention and that you're interested in what your boss is saying. Always be dependable. Build credibility and trust straight away by setting timelines and expectations on all your deliverables. Then always deliver on time. If you're delivering budgets or numbers, always double and triple check, because you don't want to be known as the one whose deliveries need to be verified. Bring solutions before you bring a problem to your boss. Make sure you think through the potential solutions or scenarios of how you want to deal with this problem. By doing this, you might even find the best way forward, so you don't even have to bother your new boss. You can then brief them in your next one-on-one on what decisions you took and why. This will quickly build your capital with your new boss. One solution, if I can suggest one, is that you hit the like button. That's the only thing I ask for making these videos available for free. Set up one-on-ones. Set up regular one-on-ones to brief your boss on your progress and your achievements. This will ensure that your new boss knows the value you're adding and the impact you're having on a regular basis. One-on-ones should be about you. In your first one-on-one though, try to make it about them, your new boss. Ask them what brought them to where they are today, what motivates them, and what does a great day look like for them. Also ask them about their strengths and if they can help coach you on those abilities. Ask for feedback. Make it a point to ask your new boss for feedback after a month and then on a regular basis after that. You want to make sure that you have no blind spot or no other issues. Ask them to always be direct with you and tell them you will be equally direct with them. And I just want to caution you not to take any of these steps too far. Everything should always be balanced. And don't overdo things and try to overperform just to switch back to your normal self after a few months. It's all about trying to step it up a notch, being mindful of your behavior and doing it all in a sustainable manner. This will not only make you look good, it will also be sustainable in the long run. If you found value in this video, please make sure you subscribe. I release videos every week, videos that add value to your life and your career. And if you have any additional tips or tricks, please leave them down in the comments. I'm on a continuous quest to learn new things and perspectives, so whatever you share is going to be valuable to me. Thank you so much for watching. See you again next week. Bye.